Good afternoon, Sean. This testing was deemed necessary after federal investigators say a former medical technician at Exeter Hospital was stealing drug-filled syringes and replacing them with syringes tainted with his blood. This is the first of 8 state-sponsored clinics.
Just before 10, people started filing into the middle school in Stratham to be tested for hepatitis C. The group consists of former patients at Exeter Hospital who had surgery or retreated in the ICU. Diana Heath says she's not nervous.
When they first announced, well, anybody who had surgery, my husband said, that's you. Oh, I guess it is. Yeah, but so just get the testing done to be on the safe side.
After passing through registration, the patients will have 2 vials of blood drawn, and what is called a rapid test, similar to a pregnancy test, will be done.
And this test paddle goes in appropriately, and it'll sit like that for 20 minutes.
The test checks for antibodies to hepatitis C, and officials say is 98% accurate.
If it's negative today, then there's an extremely high likelihood that it's going to be negative. But we are going to double check. And
if the test is positive, in addition to doctors, there are also mental health counselors on the scene.
We know some people are very anxious. Some are angry. Some are sad. Some are confused about this whole experience. And we want to make it as pleasurable as possible under the circumstances.
500 people are expected to be tested today, and officials do expect that some people will have hepatitis C, but no more than would be expected if you tested people at random, and it doesn't mean their case is connected to the outbreak.
If we test 1,000 people, you're going to find 1% of that group will test positive hepatitis C. That's just what you're going to find in the general population.
One clarification, while registration is preferred, officials say they are prepared to handle a small number of walk-ins. There is no cost to the public. Today's clinic here in Stratham runs until 6. Reporting live in Stratham, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.